Eternal Flame by the Bangles, a major hit single for them back in 89, beautiful ballad, and this lesson is primarily based on their acoustic versions, and well, even more so maybe an acoustic one that I found Susanna Hoffs by herself. At least it was like one guitar you could hear in there, and then of course her singing. So, and I took it from there. So what we have is the key of D. I am now on the 4th fret, which, well, she is as well, actually, even though sometimes they would be on the third. So depending on vocal range and stuff like that. But the original recording would be on the fourth, so the absolute key of F sharp. However, from there, relative to capo, everything is in the key of D, those shapes. We would have, like, the three major chords, so D, G, and A, the three minor chords, B minor, F sharp minor, and E minor. Several of those chords could include a dominant 7, which is really nice to do, and then there are chords out of the key, C major, or like instead of an F sharp minor, an F sharp major. Same for E minor, at one point it is actually an E major, or with a dominant 7 in there, and then you have, of course, this descending, I'm sorry, this shape, which is going like up the neck, which is basically like an A shape. If you move it to the 5th fret, you will have like three notes of a C chord from the barre family, actually. However, still with this A in the bass, and then you move it up another whole step to the 7th fret, and then you would have like D also with an A in the bass. I in particular really like it that way, even though you could also play it here and then an A minor 7 there, and then a D also with an A in the bass. Well, however, those are all the chords which will appear in the song, which I will also show you in this lesson, of course. How she strums it, by herself or with the Bangles there, is actually really straightforward, like a ballad strum. Down, something like that. Keep it simple, I would say. You could even finger pick this, or flat pick, I mean, hybrid pick it. I actually considered doing a finger style version, but whatever. Sticking to how they do it, actually. So, from there, so I will, of course, break down the strumming there, the progression, which has quite a few unusual turns. This major to minor and so on. You could have seen it actually earlier in the preview already, what is happening in there. The guitar solo is basically just playing the progression, I mean, the second part of a verse. And the outro is like the first verse, so progression-wise, even though, and the chords move pretty fast, as in every two beats there's a chord change. There are only a few spots in which you hang on to a chord for a measure or even two, and that is it. Now, I think, oh yes, one more thing, of course, because the absolute key of the original recording is F sharp, another thing which you could do is tune all strings of the guitar a half step down and then play it in the key of G. Works actually really well. I'm not a half step down now, of course. And then all the, well, you get different sounding voicings, lower, of course, even lower than I am now. And then the chords would be, well, very similar, except it's another key. So you would have like a G, and an E minor, C, D, there's also, so B minor, and there's an F in there, which would be out of the key. A D which moves up the neck to cover the chorus there, and stuff like that. So that could be interesting to some there as well. So I've added a segment in which I break down how to do it in this one. But mainly, of course, we take a look at the key of D. So maybe you can already, you know, the preview was already enough, me playing through it. But if you need more details, of course, then check it out at Totally Guitars in the Target program.